Hello friends, so in this video we are going to find out the Laplace transform of ERF root T. Now what is meaning of ERF? So ERF is nothing but error function. So it means we have to find out the Laplace of error function of root T. Now how to get the value of error function of root T? So for that we are going to use the definition of error function. So the error function is defined as ERF of T. So I am showing you the error function for T. So ERF of T is 2 by root pi integration from 0 to T e raised to minus x square dx. So this is the definition of error function of T. Now in our question we want to find out the Laplace of error function of root T. So first of all let me find out the value of error function of root T in terms of integration. So error function of root T is given by 2 by root pi into integration of 0 to root T e raised to minus x square dx. So guys, whenever this function t changes, let's say here we have root t, so that time the upper limit of the integration will change. So next time if we have 2 root t, so you have to just change the upper limit of integration as 2 root t. So now to get the value of Laplace of this, that is Laplace of error function of root t, I need to find out the Laplace of this integration. But we do not have any standard formula to get the Laplace of this integration. So hence I will first of all solve the integration. I'll convert it into some terms for which the Laplace transform is possible, and then we'll get the Laplace transform. So let's solve the integration. Now to solve the integration, here we have e raised to minus x square. Now how to get the integration of e raised to minus x square? So what I'll do is I will rewrite this e raised to minus x square in terms of algebraic terms. It means I am using the expansion of function. So let's expand the e raised to minus x square term. So this will become 2 by root pi integration 0 to root t. What is expansion of e raised to minus x square? So for that guys, we are going to use a formula. So it is formula of e raised to minus x, which is 1 minus x plus x square by 2 factorial minus x cube upon 3 factorial plus x raised to 4 by 4 factorial minus infinite terms. So this is the series of e raised to minus x in terms of algebraic function. Now if we'll compare this e raised to minus x with our term e raised to minus x square, then we can say that here x is x square. So in this whole series I will put x as x square. So here we'll get 1 minus, now here x is x square, so we'll get x square plus, now x square, but my x is x square, so that will become x raised to 4 upon 2 factorial minus x cube, so x is x square, so x raised to 6 is, it will become upon 3 factorial plus so on into dx. Now let's find out the integration of each term. So here we'll get 2 by root pi in bracket, the integration of 1 is x minus integration of x square is x cube by 3 plus integration of x raised to 4 is x raised to 5 upon 5, so that will become 2 factorial into 5 minus the integration of x raised to 6 is x raised to 7 upon 7, so 3 factorial into 7 plus, we'll get the remaining terms. Now limits is from 0 to root t. So let's substitute this limit, that is upper and lower limit, in the function. So first of all I'll substitute the upper limit. So upper limit is root t, so here we'll get x as root t. Now root t is nothing but t raised to half, so here we'll get t raised to half. So I'll say it is equal to 2 by root pi in bracket, this is t raised to half minus, now here root t cube, now root t is t raised to half, so t raised to half cube is t raised to 3 upon 2 upon 3 plus x is root t, so t raised to half raised to 5 is t raised to 5 by 2 upon 2 factorial into 5 minus x is root t, so t raised to half raised to 7 is t raised to 7 by 2 upon 3 factorial into 7 plus so on. So this is substitution of upper limit, and when we'll substitute the lower limit, so lower limit is 0, so here all terms will become 0 because x is 0, so we'll get only this much of series. So we got the expansion for error function of root t. Now as I want to find out the Laplace of error function of root t, I got the substitution of this, so now I'll find the Laplace of this substitution, so I'll put this in the bracket. So I'll say, so therefore Laplace of error function of root t is equal to Laplace of, now I'll substitute this, so it is 2 by root pi in bracket t raised to half minus t raised to 3 by 2 upon 3 plus t raised to 5 by 2 upon 2 factorial into 5 minus t raised to 7 by 2 upon 3 factorial into 7 plus so on. So here I have substituted this series. Now out of this 2 by root pi, I'll take it outside the Laplace because it is constant, and we'll find out the Laplace of each term separately. So now what is Laplace of t raised to half? So for that we are going to use this formula, that is Laplace of t raised to n is gamma n plus 1 upon s raised to n plus 1, and we use this formula if n is fraction. So here now n is a fraction and the value of n is half, 3 by 2, 5 by 2, 7 by 2, so all are fractions. So we'll get gamma n plus 1 upon s raised to n plus 1. So here in the first term the value of n is 1 by 2, so we'll get gamma 1 by 2 plus 1, so 1 by 2 plus 1 is 3 by 2 upon s raised to 3 by 2 minus, now 1 by 3 constant, let's take it outside. Now what is Laplace of t raised to 3 by 2? So it is gamma 3 by 2 plus 1, that is 5 by 2 upon s raised to 5 by 2 plus 1 upon 2 factorial and 5 outside, since it is constant. What is Laplace of t raised to 5 by 2? So it is gamma 5 by 2 plus 1, that is 7 by 2 upon s raised to 7 by 2 minus, now 1 upon 3 factorial into 7 outside, and the Laplace of t raised to 7 by 2 is gamma 7 by 2 plus 1, that is 9 by 2 upon s raised to 9 by 2 plus so on. So this is the series that we got. Now let's find out the value of gamma functions. So for that I'm going to use a formula of gamma, that is gamma n is equal to n minus 1 into gamma n minus 1. So now what is value of gamma 3 by 2? So let's use this formula. So n is 3 by 2, so here we'll get 3 by 2 minus 1, that is 1 by 2 gamma 1 by 2, and let me tell you my friends, the value of gamma 1 by 2 is root pi, so we'll get 1 by 2 into root pi. Next, what is value of gamma 5 by 2? So gamma 5 by 2 is given by the formula, same formula. So 5 by 2 minus 1, that is 3 by 2, and gamma 3 by 2, the same term. Next, what is value of gamma 3 by 2? So just now we got the value of gamma 3 by 2 as 1 by 2 root pi. So I'll substitute over here. So we'll get 3 by 2 as it is, and gamma 3 by 2 is 1 by 2 into root pi. Similarly, the value of gamma 7 by 2 is equal to, by this formula, 7 by 2 minus 1, that is 5 by 2 gamma 5 by 2. Now, what is value of gamma 5 by 2? That we got it over here, 3 by 2, 1 by 2 into root pi. So, 5 by 2 as it is, and the value of gamma 5 by 2 is 3 by 2, 1 by 2 into root pi. And the last term is gamma 9 by 2 is equal to, so 9 by 2 minus 1, so that is 7 by 2 gamma 7 by 2. So, 7 by 2 as it is, and value of gamma 7 by 2 is 5 by 2, 3 by 2, 1 by 2 into root pi. And now, we'll substitute these all values in the series. So, here I'll say it is equal to 2 by root pi. Now, when I'll substitute into series, I'll substitute these terms in the numerator. But if you'll observe the denominator, then from denominator, we can take s raised to 3 by 2 common because it is there everywhere. So, I will take s raised to 3 by 2 outside the bracket. So, from the first term, we'll get gamma 3 by 2. So, now gamma 3 by 2 is 1 by 2 into root pi minus 1 by 3. Value of gamma 5 by 2 is 3 by 2 into 1 by 2 into root pi, and out of s raised to 5 by 2, s raised to 3 by 2 is outside. So here I'll write again, that is s raised to 5 by 2 is s raised to 3 by 2 plus 1. So s raised to 3 by 2 is outside. So s raised to 1 will remain in the bracket. So here I'll say we have only s. Next, plus 1 upon 2 factorial into 5. Now, what is value of gamma 7 by 2? So, it is 5 by 2, 3 by 2, 1 by 2, root pi. And the value of s raised to 7 by 2, according to this formula, I'll say s raised to 5 by 2 plus 1. Or, I'll say s raised to 3 by 2 plus 2. So, s raised to 3 by 2 plus 2, if I'll do, then I'll get s raised to 7 by 2. So, out of that, s raised to 3 by 2 outside. So, only s raised to 2 will remain inside. So, s square is inside. Next, minus. So, 1 upon 3 factorial into 7. Here, gamma 9 by 2, the value of gamma 9 by 2 is 7 by 2, 5 by 2, 3 by 2, 1 by 2 into root pi, and this s raised to 9 by 2 we can write as s raised to 3 by 2 plus 3. So s raised to 3 by 2 is outside, so only s cube will remain inside, and that is the last term that we are considering. So now let's cancel the terms. So here I can cancel this 3 and 3. Next, here we can cancel this 5. Next, here we can cancel this 7. And from these all terms, I can take root pi outside. So, root pi will come outside. Also, I can take this 1 by 2 outside. So, we will get is equal to 2 by root pi s raised to 3 by 2 as it is. Next, this root pi is coming outside, so root pi will go in the numerator, 1 by 2 outside, 2 will come in the denominator, and in the bracket we will get from here 1 minus. Now here, since 1 by 2 is going outside, inside the bracket we will get only 1 by 2 into 1 by s. because root pi is also outside. Next, plus root pi outside and this 1 by 2 is outside. So, we will get 3 in the numerator. Here we will get 2, then 1 and 2 into 2, that is 4. Next, here we have 1 upon s square minus here this 1 by 2 is outside, root pi is outside. So, what we will get? So, in the numerator we will get 5, 3 and 1. In the denominator, observe carefully, here this 1 by 2 is outside, so we will get 2, then this 2 into 2, that is 4, and this 3 factorial is 6, and here we will get 1 upon s cube plus so on. So, I will give the bracket over here. Now guys, this 2 and 2 will be cancelled, root pi will be cancelled. And we will get 1 upon s raised to 3 by 2 outside. And in the bracket, we got this series. So, it is 1 minus 1 by 2 into x plus 1, 2, 3, 4 into x square minus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 into x cube and so on. So, actually it is a series, and it is a series of 1 plus x raised to minus half. So, here I will write it down. So, it is a series of 1 plus x raised to minus half, which is 1 minus 1 by 2 x plus 1, 2, 3, 4 into x square minus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 into x cube plus so on. So, we got this series. So, I will write it is 1 plus, what is the value of x? So, x is the coefficient of half or 1, 2, 3, 4. So, here the coefficient of half is 1 by s. So, I will say it is 1 upon s raised to minus half. So, we will get 1 upon s raised to 3 by 2 in the bracket by cross multiplication s plus 1 upon s raised to minus 1 by 2. Now, if I want to make this power as positive, then I have to take inverse. So, this will become s upon s plus 1 raised to positive half, which is equal to s raised to half upon s raised to 3 by 2 into s plus 1 raised to half. Now, s plus 1 raised to half is root s plus 1, and this will come down, and that will become 3 by 2 minus 1 by 2, that is 2 by 2, which is 1, that is only s will remain. And we will get 1 upon s root of s plus 1 as the value of Laplace of error function of root t. Thank you.